any smoke on Rocky Top, ain't no telephone bills. Once I had a girl on Rocky Top, half bear, the other half cat. Wild as a mink, but sweet as soda pop, I still dream about that.
Just outside of Nashville, Tennessee, comes a girl who's got game in just about any sport. Dorothy Hicks, everyone calls her Dot, but she's more of a blip on the athletic scene. She's a force that has opponents chasing her around the tennis and basketball courts. At Peabody College, she earns degrees in biology and physical education. At the University of Tennessee, degrees in higher education curriculum and development PE. Plus, Dot goes to the University of Pittsburgh for some advanced work. She's almost always winning. Miss Hicks teaches in public schools. She then takes a job in 1956, teaching at East Tennessee State. Here, Dot takes on an ambitious project, a synchronized swim team. She is director and choreographer. In 1969, Marshall makes a call to Dot Hicks. In the summer, she becomes the chairman of the Women's Physical Education Department. Fresh on the scene, Dot wants to make some changes to start a women's sports program. Dot works hard with Marshall students. She begins a 30-year career of teaching individual sports and team sports, including drill, technique, and analysis. Dot works with Cabell County physical education teachers and brings new ideas to programs. Meantime, with no money but plenty of can-do attitude, Dot brings women's sports to Marshall and organizes the West Virginia Association for Women Intercollegiate Athletics. The first women's sports at Marshall include volleyball, basketball, softball, field hockey, badminton, and tennis. The program grows and changes. Scholarships are added, and Title IX under the NCAA boosts women's sports across the board. Don't forget, during this time, Dot is also teaching, lecturing, and coaching at Marshall. She serves as interim director when men and women's physical education departments are merged. She's an associate athletic director, and Dot serves as faculty representative to the Southern Conference and the NCAA. Dot retires in 1999, but someone needs to explain retirement to her. She continues to work for women's athletics and playing sports, but Hicks sees it as practicing what she preaches or teaches, and that's staying active. She plays a lot of tennis and golf. She plays in a teacher's league, but Dot says the sweetest victories are those over her former students. She tries to introduce new sports to the region, but not everyone is certain about her choices, like snowblower racing. The name Dot Hicks carries a lot of respect and dignity. It represents hard work and dedication to women's sports. She's put the name to work helping the Marshall softball program, and the program is proud to name its field after her.
I'm so thrilled I've had this opportunity to speak about Dr. Dorothy Hicks. She has been such a personal inspiration to me and so many other women athletes at Marshall. She is the face of women's athletics. She single-handedly created the athletic program for women and shepherded us through the pioneer days, if you want to call them that, or the very beginnings, whenever she literally drove people in her own vehicles and they made peanut butter and jelly sandwiches. It's the people that are here don't really understand, other than they see her name and her at events and at the Dot for particularly softball players, but what she did for them, the students of today. She was a personal mentor to me and has helped me navigate my student days, my athletic days as an athlete and then as a coach, and helped me get to where I am today. She has done that for so many people and been so instrumental. I don't think Marshall and Marshall Athletics can ever repay her for what she's done.
Marshall Athletics have had many supporters, but among them, this Tennessee native, Dot Hicks, is more than just a supporter. She's a provider of scholarships, provider of facilities, and an all-around supporter of Marshall Athletics and the university. We're certainly glad to have Dot with us.
Dot Hicks has been a tremendous asset to all of Marshall Athletics. First of all, you look at Dot Hicks Field. I think that says it all. You think about the things that she's done for Marshall women's basketball, the people that she is constantly going out and recruiting to come to our games, the fact that she doesn't miss any games. She makes it fun for our girls to step out there on the court because she's brought fans to the stands. Next, she's always financially supported us. She's done everything she could to try to make sure that we had everything that we needed to be competitive in CUSA. Not only is Dot a great friend to the university, a great friend to our players, but she's been a great friend to all our coaches. We love you, Dot. Thank you for everything you've done for us, and we hope to make you proud.
We at the Marshall Foundation are so thrilled to be here and to represent and to say thank you for what you have done for Marshall University, women's athletics, and for all the students that are and will be walking Marshall's campus in the future. Your leadership, your vision, your determination and drive have done incredible things for women athletes, as well as all athletes and students at Marshall. We're humbled to say and call you our friend. Your generosity to the students and to Marshall speaks volumes about your passion and your love for education, for sports, but more importantly, who you are and who you love. And you love seeing students educated, ladies doing great things on and off the court and fields. And we're just proud to say that you are a daughter of Marshall.
Few choice words about Dot Hicks. But what can I say about Dot Hicks? She's the voice of the thundering herd, female sports. One of her key sports, women's softball. She is a big backer and a big person who always is there for women's softball. And everybody appreciates her for her time and her abilities to further women's softball. Thanks a lot, Dot.
I think anytime you think of the name Dot Hicks, you think of a huge advocate for women's sports in general. You know, each individual coach that is coaching a women's sport at Marshall University knows how much she's brought to our programs. The best part about Dot is she's there in the stands. She doesn't just support financially, she supports extremely personally. And, you know, we just truly appreciate everything she's done for women's sports in general and Marshall University.
Weather day, scrape off the ice, and just come out and have a lot of fun. Thanks, Dot.
On a personal note, I wanted to come here and thank you for taking Ralph under your wing. We moved back here in 1996. You were his confidant. You were his supporter. I know that he leaned on you a lot, and you taught him, showed him the way, who to call, who to see. You knew all the contacts, and he appreciated that so much. You helped us get M Club off the ground. You helped us in the Big Green. You helped us on the Hall of Fame committees. And I just want you to know there's so many other things. I remember Ralph saying when we would go to sporting events, You were always there. I don't care if it was volleyball, basketball, men or women. It was softball. It was baseball. It was football. Dot is always there. Thank you, Dot, for being so supportive. And on my personal note, I want to thank you for being instrumental in helping Ralph get the dugout named for me here at the softball stadium. It was probably the biggest thrill of my life. And it was very special. Just the year before, he left us. But having the dugout named for me is something I can remember him by, as well as have a part in the Marshall family. I just wanted to thank you so much for that, and sticking with him and walking him through it. I know that you did, and I love you, Dot, and thanks again for everything. Knows that I'm grateful for what he gave
me. Because of you, Dot, we can come in here and hit regardless of the weather and continue to get better each and every day.
While at Marshall, I had the opportunity to play women's golf under Dr. Dorothy Hicks, because we didn't have softball yet. It was a great experience. I got to play in a tournament with Nancy Lopez. She came in first. Me, well, that's another story. While at Marshall University, I was a PE major, and we were playing field hockey one day on that field where the education building is, and Dr. Hicks was participating with us. That's one of the lessons in life that I learned from her participant. She fell down. Don't tell her I told you that story. But I think she went on and scored a goal because we were all flabbergasted. But she gave me many opportunities, and I went on for a 20-year wonderful career with the YMCA. While at the YMCA, one of the programs that I did was an after-school middle school sports program. And about a year after we started it, I got a phone call from a young lady who said, "Miss Connie, I made the high school basketball team, and I would not have done so without you and the opportunity that you gave me." And I was able to do that because Dr. Hicks gave me so many opportunities. So on behalf of the Marshall softball players here and women everywhere who had opportunities because of you, Dr. Hicks, from my heart to you, thank you.
Wish we had time.
I know, I wish we did too.
Before Doc came to our locker room, she contacted Ron Area, and 2 days later, we had these.
Thank you!
Hello, my friend. About 10 years ago, we met through my husband, and we travel. We like Marshall so much, and I want to thank you for all the things that you do for Marshall. Good luck, my friend.
Hi, Dot. We love you. I can't wait to see you at the games. Thank you for swimming with me in Florida. Hi, Dot. Thank you for the Pinkalicious books. They're our favorite. Can't wait to
I just want to congratulate you on the awards you're receiving. I know you've received quite a few of them here at Marshall. I remember it's been quite a while since you came over here from East Tennessee to Marshall. You served as chairwoman of the Women's Physical Education, professor in health, physical education, recreation. I know you served as golf coach, faculty representative in athletics, You were on the board, the Hall of Fame committee for many years. Not only I, but I'm sure so many people here in Huntington appreciate all the things you've done for Marshall. And I just want you to know that I've been very happy to know you. And once again, congratulations on this award that you so richly deserve.
Hi, Dot. We're glad you're having this honor for you, because you really have deserved everything, all the honors that you've had. I can remember all the time we talked together and all the work that you did for athletics, for softball, for all the other sports that you taught. I remember the playoffs we went to, the trips we took together, and of all the things when you coaches went out to coach and you came in and the next day and told about cars breaking down and kids leaving and you get in 3 or 4 in the morning and go to work the next day. So it's been a great life, but you've done a lot for sports at Marshall, and all the honors that you've got, you've deserved all of them. And the girls need to, and the different teams when you served on athletic committees, all the things that you work for the school. So it's been an honor to teach with you. It's been even nicer that we knew each other and we traveled together. So it's been fun. And down memory lane, we have a lot of those memories to go by. So you just have a nice life, and congratulations.
Dr. Hicks, has been the lifeblood of the Marshall Athletic Department for many years, particularly the women's programs. In fact, she's the heartbeat of most of them. She's a tremendous supporter, very generous. If there's a banquet, she's there. If there's a luncheon, she's there. If there's a game, she's there. Marshall really has a blessing in Dot Hicks.
Hey, Dot, congratulations on your award. It's very, very well deserved. I know when I think of women's athletics, I think of you and all of the wonderful things you've done to support our athletic program, especially women's athletics. Whenever I think about what do we need, I know I can always come to you and ask, and get a very candid response. You've been outstanding, and I can't thank you enough for all you do for Marshall and Marshall Athletics.
Dot, John Sutherland, and we thank you so much for all that you do for Marshall Athletics. You have really meant a lot to us in a lot of ways, but I want to talk to you about being a fan, because there's no better fan for women's athletics than you. And what you've done is you've been at every event that you could be at, and you have supported through thick and thin, because there's been thick and thin, and you've been terrific, and we couldn't thank you enough. So we hope tonight's special for you. And if you would do me one favor, please check to see if Mike Hamrick really turned in all his paperwork, because I believe he might be a little short on his GPA. So thank you, Doc, for everything you've done for us.
Dot Hicks, you know, what can I say? One of the most special ladies Marshall University's ever had. Longtime faculty rep. Pioneer of women's athletics here at Marshall University, one of the top softball stadiums in the country, named in her honor, award after award named in honor of Dr. Hicks. I can remember coming to Marshall a long, long time ago as a student, and saw Dr. Hicks, had her for class, my brother had her for class. Saw what she did for women's athletics at Marshall University, and I can tell you, as a former student athlete, as a graduate of this fine university, and now as the director of athletics, Marshall University athletics, Marshall University women's athletics would be nowhere close to where it is today without the support, the love, the loyalty, the caring, the passion, the perseverance, roll up your sleeves and go to work attributes that Dr. Dorothy Hicks, who we affectionately call Dot, what she's done for this university. And you know, when I think of her I think about someone that's so special, someone who made this university better and who continues to make it better, who's been a great donor, has given her time, her effort, her money to make this university and this program better. And Dot, it's always great for me, again, as a former student here at Marshall, to talk about you, to think about you, and think about what you've done. And by the way, Dot, what you're going to do in the future for us, we always can count on you, but you're a very, very special lady, and Marshall University Athletics loves you, cares about you, and as a former Hall of Famer, you will never be forgotten, ever, from this day on and forever with Marshall University Athletics. Thanks, Dot, for all you do.